Peace everyone, Unmask Art here, and today I'll be showing you how to draw and color this white Labrador puppy. On the left side of the screen, you'll see the color palette I'm using. The numbers correspond to Luminance colored pencils, and I'm coloring on Stonehenge vellum paper. For those that support my channel on Patreon, the real-time drawing video of this is available to you now. Alright, so let's get started. Okay, so the first thing that I do is sketch out the puppy using my 2B mechanical pencil. And I wanted to talk a little bit about the way that I sketch and draw things out for these tutorials and for my artwork in general. I use a lot of similar techniques that I go over in my How to Draw Anime tutorial part 1. I use a lot of reference points within the subject itself to line things up. And I kind of do a lot of it in my head, but I build most of it with general shapes. And then I use the relationship of one part of the drawing to the other in order to basically triangulate where things are supposed to go. For instance, when drawing the head, I recognized that it's a very triangular shape, both in the shape of the head and in the ears in general. And then when drawing the rest of the body, particularly the placement of the paws, I paid attention to where the paws fell underneath the head and proportionally where everything lied. You can see that between the top of the head and the bottom of the paws, the eyes and the nose are kind of one third down and then one half down, and then the jaw is just about a nose width below the nose itself, and the left paw falls underneath the left eye, and the right paw falls just outside of the right eye. So those are things that I think about when I'm sketching out these drawings. The next thing that I do is I start using my 002 pencil and 802 pencil to kind of sketch in the back fur. Most of the colors here that I'm using is just the 002 and the 802 and the 803. When it comes to creating the fur texture, I'm just doing short pencil strokes in the direction that the fur grows. It's very important that you make sure that your pencil strokes are in the exact direction that the fur is growing. This is what helps create that texture and create the fluffiness of the fur. For the shadows, I'm using just the 803, and I'm not doing too much detail on the back because it's kind of out of focus, and I want to bring as much attention as I can to the face of the puppy because that's where I want the attention to be given. So when it comes to the details, I add much more of the details and contrast to the face of the puppy when I get to it. But for the most part, I'm just following the direction that the fur is growing with the 002 and the 802 pencils, and I'm just doing multiple layers, and then I use my paint thinner and number 8 round brush to blend it out. And when I'm blending it out with my paint thinner, I'm making sure that my brush strokes are in the same direction. There's a lot of play involved when you're doing fur like this because you do have some freedom as far as colors and how you lay the fur down. Basically, the way that I approach this is focusing on the direction of the fur and using my color palette effectively. Since I established my color palette very clearly, I didn't have to second guess which colors I was using. Now, when it comes to the paws, the darker parts of the paws, I use the 803 to color in where they are, and then I use the 866 to get that kind of fleshy tone color in there. And then at the very bottom, I use the black, and you'll see here that I use my paint thinner to blend those out a little bit. And really, I don't add any more detail to the bottom part of the paws because, like I said, most of the detail is going to be put into the face so that your attention is drawn there as opposed to at the feet. Once the paint thinner dries on the back of the puppy, I go through again with my colors and start adding a little bit more texture and detail and value to the back. Now, like I said, I don't want to add too much here because I don't want there to be an overabundance of detail in the back. I kind of want it to be soft, blurry, and out of focus looking. So I don't add too much. And when I blend it out, I'm pretty generous with my blending, and I'm not too concerned about keeping those pencil lines sharp and clean. For the most part, the undercolor of the fur is the 002, And then I use the 803 to kind of block in where those shadowed parts of the fur come in. Also, I incorporate the 660 into the fur by doing just the softest layer on the back and on the arms. You can see here after I blended it out that it shows up a bit brighter. When you're working with white fur, you can kind of think of the fur as being reflective or almost translucent in some cases, because it tends to reflect the surrounding that the animal is in. For instance, if this puppy was laying in grass, you'd see a lot of green on the underbelly because the grass would be reflecting in the white fur. And the reason I use blue on the backs and on the top parts is because it's reflecting the sky. It's kind of difficult to set this drawing on a white piece of paper because the reflections might not make sense at first, but once it's complete, it settles in quite well. Now that I'm moving on to the face, the way that I start is I add the under colors of the eye. You can see I added the bright 660 on top and the 037 on the bottom. And what that is that's going to be the reflection of the sky and the reflection of the ground. After that, I do a little bit of work on the nose with just the black. And then I go back to the eyes, and this is where I add the dark parts of the eyes. And I kind of cut out the highlights by avoiding those parts where I colored blue and brown. The next thing I do is I add the mouth using the black, and I kind of gave the dog a little bit of a smile. Once I did that, I took my 002 and I kind of outlined the rest of the puppy just so I knew exactly where everything was going to be. And I started using the 002 as an undercoat of the face so that I could kind of map out the direction that all the hair was growing. And this kind of made layering a bit easier with the other colors because I could do it with a bit more confidence. It's hard to see this color showing up much right now, but once it's blended out, you can see the bluish tint that it gives the fur. But for the most part, this is kind of a guide pencil because it's so light. I can kind of color over everything before going in with some of my darker colors to shade the drawing. Now I switch over to my 802 and start doing a bit more of the valued colors in the fur, and just following the pencil strokes that I did with my 002 pencil. When working on the face, I go much slower and I'm much more conscious of where my lines are going because I really want to create that realistic look. Though I didn't go super realistic with this drawing, with just a few simple techniques, you can make the drawing look really nice. And at this point, it's really just a layering process. I also add a little bit of the 866 around the eyes, because when you blend it out, you kind of get that peachy flesh tone color. I use it a bit around the mouth and the nose as well. It kind of separates those parts from the fur, lets it stand out a little bit more. I also incorporate a bit of the 037 on the underside of the ears. You can see it in the shadows between the eyes and the ears, just a little bit. I also incorporate it a little bit underneath the mouth. It's nice to take these colors and kind of mix them up and just play with them. It really helps bring everything together when the color doesn't just show up in one area. Then I use the 069 to darken some of the darkest parts of the shadow under the ear and beside the eyes, and also underneath the head. This helps lift the head up off the body a little bit more, gives it more contrast, and makes it stick out a bit more. Here you can see that I used the 660 and just touched a little bit of the upper side of the dog's head to give that sky reflection that I have in the rest of the body. Then I go through with the 802 and do a little bit more outlining just to help get the dog up off the paper a bit more. This is the problem with not doing a background with this piece. Because it's white paper and a white dog, I kind of have to push my colors a little bit farther than I would initially had I put a background in. Because a lot of what makes a white dog look white is the contrast that you have from the surrounding. The last little bit of detail that I add is just some white. I use that to add a few whiskers, and then I use the 802, 803, the 660, the 866, and the 009 to create the shadow underneath the dog. This was kind of a last minute decision, but I think that it really helped the dog sit on the paper much nicer. All right, everyone, here's the finished product. I hope you enjoyed the video and found it helpful. Remember that if you'd like to see the real-time video, to head over to my Patreon page. Otherwise, be sure to subscribe, give the video a thumbs up, and I'll see you next time. Take care. Peace.